My name is Patrick Alleyne. I work here at the Greater London Authority. I've been here for 9 years. I work as a senior human resources manager and use XpertHR on a fairly regular basis. It sits on my desktop. It's one or two clicks away in terms of the mouse. It's web driven, which is fantastic. I love the idea of being able to get legal advice and put a question in. A couple of hours later, you get a response. If you need to follow up, there's that opportunity. Navigating around is really, really good as well. And the other thing that I particularly like is the opportunity to email particular articles off to colleagues. Well, very often, because human resources is such a sort of dynamic environment, and no two questions are ever the same, and so sometimes you just need that reassurance that the advice that you're about to give a manager, who's then going to act upon that, and of course there could be implications for the organisation, that that advice is absolutely right. So being able to just ask the question via XpertHR is really helpful. If it's just about refreshing my knowledge, if it's about a new topic and I want to find out something, just going on, getting access to that information absolutely immediately is really, really helpful. I mean, we do have a legal team here, but sometimes they're not always available, but it means I have got a resource that's there and instant. In terms of accuracy, of the information that's on the site, I've got no questions about that at all. I think it's absolutely excellent. There is probably more information on there than I can access because I don't have the time to act and, you know, just sit and read and read and read information. But what I want, generally, I can always find on XpertHR. Well, XpertHR, one of the good things about it is that you can set up your own profile. And by setting up your own profile, that allows you to identify your industry sector, mine being local and public sector, local government and public sector. That's absolutely fine. What also happens is once you've set your profile up is actually you get bulletins that come through, and mine I get 2 or 3 a week, and they have key topics based on the kind of things that I've said I'm interested in. So immediately, you know, on three mornings a week when I get in, there's an email there waiting for me and it's got a list of relevant topics. I'm able to access those topics, have a quick flick through. If there's anything that catches my eye, I can have a read of it. If it's something that's broader than what I need, I think, yep, I need to send that off to a few other colleagues. I can immediately email that article off. So I think that's really, really good as well. We've used XpertHR recently to help us work through some issues in respect of a redundancy program that we've been running. And what we wanted was some very clear and very specific advice about things like the calculation date for redundancy purposes, exactly what that means, because we have a number of people here at the GLA who are working not on their standard contract but on alternative contracts, and we just wanted to make certain that in terms of calculating their redundancy that we were getting that right, that we were using the right rate of pay and so on. And actually what XpertHR did for us was it was able to clarify exactly what rate of pay we should use, because it gives you the formula that you need to apply, it tells you what the relevant dates are that you need to just go back and have a look at in terms of determining what salary is applicable. So for things like that, it's been absolutely invaluable. And there's been a number of other ways in which we've used XpertHR in respect to redundancy policy, just checking out the provisions in respect of maternity, just ensuring that we get that absolutely right, because of course the implications for sex discrimination are very, very significant, because of course compensation isn't capped if you get that wrong. So just being able to use that, fantastic. Absolutely, we don't want to get any of our casework wrong. We don't want to, if it's redundancy or maternity or discipline or grievance, we want to get it right. The kind of sector that we work in, what we need to do is we need to ensure that we're always giving the taxpayer value for money. And that's very different to the private sector who, you know, very often will throw money at a problem. We have to be more creative. We have to use procedures. We have to use the law. And if we have to use the procedures and we have to use the law, then what we need is a resource that's going to give us the information to ensure we use it so we get it right. When we first bought XpertHR, our account manager came along and did a demonstration to give us a little bit of initial training. And on a couple of occasions when I've had new users come on to use it, we've contacted the account manager who's just talked them through the navigation on the telephone. Those conversations are very short conversations because just navigating, it's web-based, simple. I think I would sum up XpertHR as being the font of all knowledge in terms of information that you need there at your fingertips, accessibility, because it is so accessible, and in terms of learning and how you use it, it is so straightforward because there are very few people nowadays who do not know how to navigate the web. And the fact it's a web-based product means that everyone can use it with very little training.